Once upon a time, many, many years ago, I used to have some hair. And on top of that, as a child, I used to really irritate my parents because I used to dismantle lots of my toys that I used to have just to find out how they worked. And well, things haven't really changed that much all those years later. Double socket here. It's an MK one, not that the brand really matters, because what I wanted to do is I just want to rip it apart and I'll show you how it all works inside the back of one of these sockets. So it's a metal-clad double socket by MK with USB. It's only a 15 watt output, and the camera zooms in. So it's a double pole switch. Like I just said, it's a maximum 15 watt output on the USB. Now, if you're interested, MK do a much more powerful one. They do one that's up to 30 watts, and you can check out the video up here later on if you like. But going back into this one, we can see that we have obviously the live terminal, the neutral terminal, and the earth terminal is just over here and here. We have the metal bar that joins the earths all the way around, and you can also see the little rivets which go through to the front so that when you screw the socket into your back box, you're also earthing that back box. But it's also highly recommended and good practice if you actually use an earth tail in there if you ever do that. But anyway, let's take the screwdriver to these screws, get it open and see what it's all about. Before I get carried away, just removing these four screws, as I just said to you, that there are a couple of rivets on either side on there. So I'm going to drill those out first, because obviously they're holding this entire earth bar in place, which is going to prevent me from removing the plastic cover. So let's get the drill out and get those out. A good job of ripping part of that earth bar off as well. Anyway, just sort that out shortly. So I'll just come over to this side, it's a bit cleaner. See that removing that has now removed the faceplate from the actual cover. So that's one thing to do away with straight away. And then you can see you've got all the mouldings for the switch gear and the socket input, USBs, so they can flush with the face of the metal. Anyway, the interesting bit, there's my screwdriver. Let's get this open. So, four screws. Now I'm half expecting this to completely bounce out at me in a minute. Of springs flying everywhere, bits of metal and plastic holding it all together, but we shall see. Not quite undone. So let's go. Oh, there's a clip in somewhere. So we're held in at the bottom here as well. Small screwdriver. There we go, a couple of little lugs just holding the back. It's very well, very, very well built, this, I have to say. Right, and there we have it. So this is where your plug goes into. So you have your three pins, obviously on your socket, and then they will go through the mechanism at the front of the plate. It's all quite fun trying to do this in front of a camera. So you can see how that goes in. It's actually a really clever idea, that, actually. As you can see, normally you wouldn't be able to poke anything into the front, which is a really good safety feature that all double sockets have. But MK seemed to have gone a little bit further with this. You can see that as I push it in, the bit of plastic actually slides down and actually clips around into a bit of moulding there, which is really nice Really nice, clever feature that. And you can see that that's basically the copper clips. So obviously upside down, so I'm just doing that, and that's essentially what your plug plugs into when you stick it into your socket. Obviously you've got tiny little contacts on the top there, which, if I turn this around the right way, get these screws out of the way, if you come into here, you see the, as I move the switch, you see you've got the two terminals which would marry up with these two terminals. And the double pole thing on here is literally, it does both the live and the neutral at the same time on the switch. So you can see they're both switching at the same time. Now if I get this round the right way, so I think if I'm correct, that's, and that will be the live, the neutral. Right, so let's just get one of these switches out of the way. There we go. And so you've got the little contacts on the back of the switch, again for double pole, so you've got the two points on here, and I bet, yeah they are, they're spring loaded these. What if I can get one out? No, they can't, but you can, my finger's getting in the way there. So they're spring loaded. There's a lot of engineering that's gone into making this double socket. And yeah, I see, I was right, that's a, I think that's a neutral tail going down to the circuit board for the USB chargers. It's obviously the little transformer for it. Let's get out the other, take out the other switch on the other side. This is certainly not going back together again afterwards. Story of my life. Okay, so I just drop the contacts back in again. You can see exactly how the plug fits in. That would go in just like so. So with that in mind, we can see that this will be the neutral on this side, which comes all the way around. Comes around, there's a copper bar here. Get all the way across and it links to the neutral there. This is obviously the live. Same thing again, comes all the way through. There's the crossover at the back, all the way down to the other side. Now, what's really nice about this, as I can see, this is all copper and brass, which makes it really good for contact. It's much better than steel, although they have obviously used galvanized steel for the earthing points. Now this spring here, I'm assuming must work with the, for the earth catch to lift it up and down, which, yep, there we go. Really simple idea, but it didn't fall out when I took it all apart. The only thing that came out were the connector points, if you like, contacts for the actual plug socket. So if I just shake this upside down, you get the little metal lugs for the other contacts, which were in here. So that's pretty much the lowdown on the double socket. I mean, you can just see the quality of how it's made. There's even a QR code in there. Maybe I'll have to look that one up, see what that's about. But it's a really nicely designed double socket. It's all neat in there, there's no jagged edges, there's no sharp edges for you to catch yourself on. Not that you would actually take one of these apart anyway. But it's just, I just love the engineering on this. It's simple but precise and just really, really well done. And you can see where the value of the socket all comes into on here. I mean, the fact that it's all held together really nicely for the most part, obviously you've got moving parts. Which do fall out if you were to put these, take this apart. Anyway, so there we have it. I mean, that is the inside of a double socket with USB. And I think that's quite fascinating, really, but that's my boring geek side coming out. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this little teardown of this double socket with me, this little journey into geekdom. And if you've got any questions, please put them in the comments down below. Don't forget to like and subscribe because they all really, really help the channel. And until next time, thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon.